There will be violence and profanity in this documentary. Parental discretion is advised. This is a documentary about real people and real events. Many of the voices you're about to hear belong to young people who will talk about crimes they have committed. For some of them, there have been multiple arrests and multiple convictions. Over the past 9 months, we asked them to show us how they live their lives. They agreed to cooperate and were aware that their voices and actions were being filmed and recorded for inclusion in this documentary. We sought out these young offenders to better understand why youth crime has increased so dramatically. We also sought to understand why the largest part of this crime increase was urban and lower class. Names have been withheld to protect our subjects. This program has been recommended by the National Education Association.
I've been hanging out on the street since I was 11. When I started hanging out at 11, I knew what to do when I was 12.
The street is the place where you become a man.
The streets will make you a man if anything.
We hustle to stay alive.
Like, when you got money, you got a lot of people with you. Ain't got money, ain't nobody with you.
You got that money, you know, people looking to give you that respect. You're strong, man. You got that power, man. Can't nobody tell you nothing.
Shocking, shooting at each other. I like danger, cause it's real.
When you're on the street, you cannot have a conscience. When it's dark, on the cover of darkness, you dig, everybody's a king. After all the fun and all, you know, the money and all the excitement is over, you ain't got nothing but pain.
I've never lived home, you could say, even till today.
I really have nobody to bring me up, you know, so I used to stay on the roof with the birds. I used to sleep inside the coop. I used to sleep with them. And it's summertime, so I'd sleep on the roof, in the hall, or stuff like that. But that's all I had, you know, the birds. Like they perform for you. You're the boss. You're in control. I outside, you feel like nothing. You have nothing going for yourself. You know, up here, you got, you know, the pigeons, and you control them. Like, you feel like a general. You feel like somebody. Out in the street, you feel like nothing. I've seen so many things, like the cops beating, they hit on us. What you think? So you think by just hitting on us that we're gonna change, or we get, no way. It just get worse. Don't you see we've been getting hit ever since we were born? You think we're gonna start like that? No way. No way. Just grew up with hatred. My father always hitting us, you know, hitting me all the time. He almost killed me. He just kept on hitting me. Lucky for my mother, I think he would have killed me. I was about 14 at the time. And I got away. Somehow I slipped away. I got away. And I got away and I just ran straight from my house. Just ran all the way to the other side of the neighborhood. And I seen a Jewish boy. And I took a baseball bat and I cracked his head. Just cracked him over the head.
Better after that?
Yeah, it felt real good. Real good. And from there on, I started breaking a lot of heads. I was breaking everybody's head. I mean, when we used to get in gangs, that's all I did. We grabbed a group of guys, break their heads. Break all their heads. So you crack their heads. I used to get a thrill. I used to love it. Get a thrill out of it, breaking heads. See all that blood and all that stuff. Hit them with a fork over the head. You know, bicycle fork, anything. You know, like certain guys like to stab. I like to break heads. Any bad thing you can think of, I've done. Ripping people off, mugging people, I got into that, you know. Burglarizing the stores out here. Oh, forget it. I tell you right now, I alone have cost this city thousands, tens of thousands of dollars. Vandalizing, ripping the schools off, hacksawing the parking meters. I tell you, I cost the city a lot of money. Like I'm always out in the street. All summer, for about 3 or 4 summers outside in the streets. Like animals. Just like animals, savages. With the boots, engineer boots, and the bandana, and like pirates. That's the only thing we had going for ourselves. Like animals. We're raised up like animals, so we act like animals. We just wanted to feel important, you know? That's when we started the gang. Together, people could see, oh, wow, look at that gang. Feel good, you know? Being recognized, you know? Good feeling, feel important. I used to go on a rampage, grab 5 guys on the subway, take them all off, go back downstairs, take another guy off. And one night over $1,000, here's a guy, he's making a phone call, yoke him, strip him. We're dragging this guy in the middle of the night on the ice, with his pants stuck onto his shoes, they won't come off, just dragging him down the block, naked. Funniest thing.
You say crime doesn't pay, let me tell you something, crime pays. Don't tell me crime don't pay, because it does. I've made $100 a day. Where the hell am I going to make that in a factory, in these shit jobs they offer? All these shit jobs, you think we're going to go for the shit that our parents gone for? We're not going to go for these cheap jobs. If we don't get good jobs, crime is always going to exist. And they say crime, that we. What about the big people like that, you know, that commit all the big crimes? What about them? Huh? They're the real criminals. This guy does 10 years, but then this other guy, a politician, the big guy here, a couple of months and he's out of jail. What kind of shit is that? I mean, you think we're not aware of these things? Oh, come on. You know, and it just makes it worse. And until they do something about us, something for us, and give us a chance, this is going to continue on. It's not going to stop. It's just going to get worse. And you can't get, you can get rid of me. You can get, there's going to be more to come, always. You're going to have to eliminate all of us if you want this to stop. And you can't do that. You can't push us on the cycle. We are here. You can't just ignore us because we exist. We're here and you can't. We're going to be here always. So why not give us a chance? Why not?
If they don't want to help us out, we're not going to stop. We're going to get even worse. We're going to tear, rip, break, everything we can get our hands on.
Come on.
Yo, watch my grandma get you like.
We're going to start again. Come on, break it up.
Should have killed the guy.
No, man. I don't know. You don't got to be so scared.
That simple marijuana case?
Yeah.
It might have been nice if you would have gone to court for that.
Yeah, bro, but I had to do something, man. Yeah. I went to Ohio, man, because I don't...
Yeah, I know you went to Ohio. Meanwhile, you got one wire. If you didn't come back by April 6th, you would have blown that whole case. You know that, right? Yeah. The one with the old lady?
I got a chance, huh?
Yeah, you got a chance, especially if you would be doing things.
Because I went, right? I went this morning.
Yeah.
Because I went to see, you know, but I didn't know where was it. I got lost.
But I want to clear that warrant that you got, maybe even tomorrow. And then I want you doing things that are going to look good for family court.
Yeah, I went over there because I want to think, Bob, man. I want to think a lot of things.
Well, why don't you drop by tonight, man, without all your crimes, and tell me what you've been thinking about. I'm worried about the 70-year-old lady.
Case that you just had in court. Shook up 70-year-old lady. How much money did you think she might have?
I don't know. I didn't got nothing at all.
And you got nothing at all is right. Why you went and you did it?
We just needed money.
Now, I saw that lady, Pete.
She didn't even have to sell him, man.
I saw that lady when we had the lineup for his brother.
50s, man. Right? Still, man.
That lady was obviously old. That lady could hardly walk, man.
Oh, shit. I didn't see her walking, you know? I didn't see her walking. Like, I didn't see her
walking. At this moment.
I just opened the door, you know? It's amazing, you know?
All you did was hold the door, all Ricardo did was hold the door, and all Booney did was hold the door. I don't understand how this lady lost her pocketbook. Somebody must have ran out and grabbed that pocketbook and saw the loot.
I used to rip off anybody. You know what I mean? Anybody. Anybody. If you had the money I need, I didn't care what age you were.
As you grab a guy, and you've got him where you want him, man. He's going to give you what he wants, you know? You see the fear in his eyes. And you know, man, like, this nigga is yours. You know, it don't matter. Any cop car could come down, man. You still got that dude. He ain't gonna even scream. Do you enjoy that feeling?
I do. Because I enjoy that I'm bad, you know? Because I get over, you know?
That's when I really started getting known. That's when my name, like your name just established.
I sat down with a guy at the end of a summer once on 12th Street. Figured out $128,000, roughly, had passed through this guy's hands. All he had to keep to show for it at the end of the summer was three shirts and one pair of pants out of $128,000. You know, that tells me somehow that the ripping off for money ain't what it's about at all. The ripping off for the power, it's a way of getting known, getting a reputation.
We're gonna make them cops come everywhere.
The streets are where everything happens. It's where you can go and stake out a piece of who you are.
Oh my God.
Crime, hustling, violence, everything comes from the family.
But it just started in my house, getting hit every day.
When my father hits me, I just feel like going to hit somebody or take them off. Makes your pain go away.
I was just an ordinary nice kid. I mean, we're not born criminals, you know.
No mother won't give you nothing. You got to go out there and steal it.
My mother's a drug addict and my father's still an alcoholic. So I started hanging out with my friends.
See, my mom's, she's all right, man. But, like, I just love the streets. I love to be out in the streets and doing whatever I be doing.
Our parents bring their frustrations out on us. We can't take it out on them because they're higher. Just like kings and queens, so we take it out on somebody else, you dig?
where we are the kings and queens out in the street. We have our little subjects running around here, and those are the ones that we rip off and terrorize.
I've been working ever since I was 13 years old. Been out on my own ever since I was 17.
And kicks the dope, man.
My kids just think it's easy. They just, I don't know. I have 11. That's five in jail. They don't know what it is to get up in the morning time, go to work, and come back in the afternoon and say, I work today. They've never had a job. All their life, I work the father. Took care of his disease. So now he's gone. I'm still doing it. When the father was here, it was easier. Oh yeah, they was afraid of the father.
We have the kids sitting on the refrigerator to keep them warm. The heat goes up in.
Is your coffee?
Oh yeah. I'm tired of water. This is a dog gonna say, oops, don't let me burn my hand. Oh, take it easy. Whew. And so this water is
definitely. We have heat about a good week in a month. And the man got nothing to talk about. He's going up on rent. And we can't even get no hot water, no heat. I don't like this at all. Don't make no sense.
Mary, how do you feel about all this?
Rotten.
What's rotten?
The whole thing. No food most of the time. I'm talking.
So get up out my seat.
Yeah, another thing. My nephew, he see other kids out there dressed better than he do. He wants some of the things that he see out there. And we can't do that. And so that's why kids get out here and steal today.
You know, I go downtown with somebody and I see something I want. I just go in the room where you change that and put it on and put my clothes over top of them, come on back out and leave. Then I go somewhere and take it off. Put in a shopping bag and hide it and go back and get what else I want.
Knowing you could get arrested, knowing you could go to jail, does that scare you?
No. Probably when I get older it will, because I'll be going to prisons and stuff.
Okay, sure.
But now don't, because when they send you, I'll come home every week and stuff. And I'll be right back home about every week. And when I come home, I'll be still doing the same thing.
We got to have some money for someplace.
Can you make as much money working as stealing?
You make much money stealing. You make more stealing.
No,
Because sometimes I go out there and I steal, I bring about in the house $300 or $400 sometimes.
Hey, Dave, Timmy,
go ahead.
You get tired. You get up, you go to work, you come back, and it's the same old thing. Every day. Nobody working but me. Nobody cares but me. And I just done got tired.
Shelly, how do you like watching?
Yeah, if I could just go and keep on walking, I'd just keep on walking. And I wouldn't come back. When the father was here, it was easier. Oh yeah, they was afraid of the father. They know he didn't believe in going to no jailhouse, getting nobody out. If the police didn't bring them to him, he wouldn't sign them out.
I really thought some of them was gonna grow up to be something, but look like to me, from the oldest on down, ain't gonna be nothing. It makes you feel bad, but to me, seems like to me, they don't care. They just keep on with the same old thing, over and over, over and over. Fast as they get out, they go right back.
If you see something and you want it and you haven't got the money,
I mean, I still it. Well, I'm telling the truth. That's the way I feel.
Well,
about
then,
it.
Come on.
I'm not supposed to steal.
How is it that you have six kids who feel differently?
They got a different mind.
I feel that they don't really have to pay for it because I can get it be out paying for it.
How does it make you feel that I came in here and I left with less money?
Now, that really got me. Because out of all people in the world, they should not have took your
pocketbook. Right now, I ain't touched the lady pocketbook.
Me?
I ain't have nothing to do with the pocketbook. I was in the front room when the crime took place. I was in the front room, and the victim was back here. The victim took the belongings. The victim went over in the corner, then the victim went out that door. And now the victim is gone.
That's the victim.
No name has been spoken yet.
Peggy. I already know who it is.
My mother came home.
I stopped stealing as much as I used to. I sold a lot. But I don't do it as much as I used to. You know, every once in a while.
Typical day here.
I be thinking about where I'm going to go to make me a couple dollars at that day. Then I stake out my place and I go on and do. But now my partner in jail, I got to find me somebody new. Until I get caught.
But that won't be long.
I tell you, I wake up with love on my mind.
Well, that was a good one. Now, what did it do to you?
You wanted something and you wanted to take it. What line would you draw?
If I had to hurt somebody, I won't take it.
You have hurt people.
Yeah, because he hurted me.
You've never hurt anybody unless they hurt you first?
Like, I be messing somebody. Yeah, I done ran up to men and hit them in their face, but dog, that don't hurt them. You know, that sort of just give them something to think about. It don't hurt them.
It's bad. If I had to stay here with him all the time, I think I'd go crazy. Because I couldn't take it.
When me and him separated, well, when he left, the whole attitude changed. They changed. Seems like to me they just figure, so, oh, well, he's nobody but mom. We can do anything we want on now. No matter what I did for him or how I tried, it didn't make sense. The way they changed, you know, the way they went, the way they did. So I never could figure them out myself.
We just hang out here for snaps, dance and everything. Can't go in there at night. The junkies will get you. So I have candles for light. So this man came in, he chased us with a knife all around the building, man. You see it like mice. You see us coming out of holes. Wherever you walk, you gotta watch your back. They can shoot at you, they can do anything. You gotta protect yourself when you're around here. You let them shoot on you, they'll do it all the time. That's why you gotta get back at them, show them you're not a punk.
What is a punk?
A person that likes to get beat up by. Like they, like a bully, make believe a bully comes and beats you up and you don't hit them back, you're a punk.
What do you do if a bully, say you walking down the street by yourself and a bully comes up and takes you?
I hit him with a baseball bat. If I got one. If I got a stick, I'll hit him with a stick. I got a bottle, I hit him in the head with a bottle. I got coffee, I spill coffee in his face and then I kill him. Throw him under a car. I put this guy's hand under a car. Put his hand like that. Car ran over his hand. Well, I was in 18th Street with my friend Cash.
Why did you do that?
I don't know. I just felt like doing it because the guy got wise with me and I just wanted to show him he's a chump. Nothing happened to his hand. He just crushed it a little bit.
What happened the time the guy with the ice pick? What did you do then? What did he do to you?
Nah, he said I hit his mother, and I didn't hit his mother. And he come pulling out this blade, so I stabbed him with an ice pick.
Isn't ice pick a fairly good weapon?
Yeah. Tunnel bleeding.
Did your father ever file under tunnel?
Sometimes he'd be beating me up, right? I laughed at him, and I hit him back, and then after I hit him back, I said, let me stop, because he'll keep on. So I started laughing at him. I said, ha-ha, you feel better now? Now you got it off your chest. Sometimes I just stay there. I hold myself tight, so when he hits me, it don't hurt me. If I stop breathing while he's hitting me, it's going to hurt me.
When your father was beating on you, and then you would go out on the street and take somebody else off, is there a connection between the two?
I don't know if there is, but it feels to me when my father hits me, I just feel like going to hit somebody or take them off, because it takes the pain away from you. Like, you get like paranoid when you get hit, whatever, and you feel kind of messed up inside, so you're gonna take it out on somebody else. When you take it out on somebody else, it makes your pain go away, makes you feel better.
I whacked him, sure I whacked him. If he does something wrong, I'll whack him. I'll take his pants down, I'll go right to the school and take his pants down in front of the class.
You told me that one of the reasons you didn't punish your kids more is that you feared that the courts would intervene.
Which is true, because I had it already with my daughter. I smacked my daughter and this and that, and she went brutally.
Kenny has told us that sometimes when you hit him, it makes him so upset and angry that he goes out on the street and hits other people and mugs them.
No. I don't hit Kenny that much, but when I hit him. He feels it. Maybe that's why. But when I hit him, he understands he's got hit. If I have to sit in the jail for a day or two for doing it, I'll do it. And I'll still do it as long as I'm living.
Where I live, this is a bad neighborhood. Everybody around there would be getting high and drinking, the worst. My mother's a drug addict and my father's still an alcoholic. Some kids would make fun of me, you know, your mother's doing this and your father's doing this. So to be part of, I would go and join them. So we would go to Prospect Park. Either we take some bikes or we rip off some kids and things like that.
I started messing with drugs, and if you wasn't into drugs, you were a square. Before I knew it, I was hooked.
I would see her bringing people to the house to get high, and I was in my own little world. I didn't care, and I felt that she didn't care.
He was so angry at me. He didn't care what he had to do, so he could get away from home and be with that crowd and be a part of. And I know I drove him there.
why you used to get high and everything? I used to tell you don't stay with those people. So I would go outside and get high, go stealing and everything. I didn't care.
I would know my kids need shoes. And I would get high first.
I don't care what happened to anybody. I don't care if the kids didn't eat. I don't care if they didn't sleep. I don't care if they slept on sheets for 4 weeks. I didn't care. As long as I had what I wanted.
And then as you started growing up and going to school and getting into all these fights, and me, I didn't know what to do. I didn't know to be a father to you, a mother.
You were there and I wanted a brother, you know, a nice family, like some other kids I knew. You and you would be getting high, then I'd go with Daddy and he'd be getting drunk and everything. So I just felt like, you know, yeah, I'd be like dying and killing you and killing Daddy and everything. Just like giving a damn. Sorry, too much. Sorry. I'm so sorry, Jerome. I must have been like, say where Mr. Mike. You ain't learning nothing. We writing every day. Writing don't make you learn nothing.
I think that most teachers, they don't give a damn. I mean, they look at this as
It's just a job, you know. They come in here, they gonna get
paid. And they just write on the board, and we just copy it.
You don't even know nothing, but right. They can still be passionate.
What is our topic for today? What is our topic?
Reading.
Okay. The first thing we do is put down reading in our notebook. Everyone has their notebook out. The topic is reading.
I wouldn't mind going to school if I knew how to read.
Today. Who can tell me?
Wish you should go on to school if you don't read, because the teachers ain't going to teach you. Yes. So, might as well not go to school.
Let's open up our books, please, to page 37. Gaiman, would you read number 5, please, and give me your answer? What is that word, Gaiman? Come on, you know that word. Come on.
Since Alexander Graham Bell invented how complicated, and I'm scared to read out to the class so they can laugh some. That's what's stopping me.
Increased.
So,
what grade do you think he's reading on?
He's reading about, they say fifth grade.
Mixed.
Really, I think he's reading about fourth grade level.
And he's in the eighth grade and don't even got third, fourth grade reading level.
Tell her how you feel and you can't read.
Bad.
Tell me about
that. Don't make you feel good. People reading, you're not reading. Tell.
Do you ever mess up in class because you don't know how to read and stuff like that? Because you can't do what the rest of them do? You be cutting the food, doing things you don't supposed to be doing?
Mm-hmm.
Like, tell them what you be doing when you can't read and stuff like
that. Can't read, you play with your pencil. You play around with the book.
I mean, get serious in what you be doing. Tell her.
Acting like a fool. There's a lot of people, other people in my class be doing the same thing. They be talking.
That mean they can't read too, that mean? Mm-hmm. Something like that? So all of y'all be sticking together. All of y'all that can't read, y'all just hang out.
Mm-hmm.
All right, now once they started hanging out together, then they get tight. Then that one said, let's play hooky, man, we ain't learning that no way. So let's cut out.
Lining
in
the
stomach.
And that's when you get to the point that kids drop out of school. What they do, they jump into crime. Because that's the only thing that's giving them money. They can't jump out of school into a job because there's no jobs.
I don't want to grow up like they out of school. They ain't learn nothing. I'm going to make my life out of something. I'm going to try. Learn how to read.
I'm up in my 20s. I can't even read. I can't get a good job. What it feel like? Feel like, man, what can I say? I can't do nothing. I can't function right.
I can't even read the paper that good. Say if I want to be a judge or something, I can't even read the book. So without reading, ain't nothing. Life ain't nothing.
What you think you're going to do? Just tell them.
I think I'm going to be sitting on the bench. You know, with bummy clothes, that's what I think.
What do you fear is going to happen?
I'm going to wind up going to jail or something like that. Okay. Might steal. Okay. I don't really know.
I think if you could read it, make a big difference.
Yeah.
Hey, this guy's got it. They're going for him.
Huh?
Open it up.
You steal, man. You go to jail, you come back out, deal again. You go to jail, you come back out. That's all it is, one cycle.
Court is a waste of time. They smack you on your hand, and then you're gone again.
Who do you want to see, man?
Larry Farm and Charles Farm.
I get tired of going backwards and forwards from jail to jail, visiting different places. Maybe if the jails was a little bit tougher or they was locked up longer, it would make a difference.
Now, how long you been going to jail? No, I'm serious. How long?
Too long.
Ever since you was, 16 years old? You've been in, out, in, and out. if you was to try to stay out, you would stay out.
Talk about that. I don't even feel like talking. I'm tired. I don't feel good. I'm locked up.
I know. Yeah, you tired. You don't feel good. You locked up. So you've been going to jail ever since you was 8. And you 29. And you say you tired. I'm the one tired. You see, I get tired of showing my face. It ain't a police in town. Really don't know me.
Now, I can get out today if you got $20.
He got the rest of the money. All they need is $20.
Mm-hmm. No, you don't need no $20. Just stay in.
Set the 20. No, I don't want to stay in.
Set the 20 out. This way I won't have no money involved in it. You owe me nothing. I won't owe you nothing.
Listen, I'm talking about me now.
Well, I ain't got no $20. And I ain't gonna give you no $20.
My $20, Lord, no. If a person did a crime, I think they should be punished. And I think they should stay there quite, you know, a long period of time, not just go in and come right out.
I wasn't really doing nothing but taking people money, that's all. Just running up and down the street when I see little kids come out the food market, take their money.
Jimmy?
I was just about 11 or 12.
When we last spoke together, you were very clear about what you thought about the juvenile justice system, that you didn't take it very seriously, and now they've caught you and you're back in Jamesburg. Have your feelings changed at all?
No. They just caught me because I was breaking in the house, that's all.
Tell me a little bit about how many institutions you've been in and what kind of arrest record you have.
What kind of arrest record? What you mean? Or like what I'm getting arrested for? Not going to school, taking people money, breaking in houses.
There was an assault charge also, Timmy.
Where'd that come from? Oh, you talking about when I assaulted that milkman? Oh yeah, the assault.
How many times have you been arrested?
I don't know, I can't count. About 30 or 40 times.
The first time you were sent here, Stanley was here, your brother. And when he heard that you were coming, he began to weep in front of everybody.
Weep? What you mean, weep?
He was crying.
So, what did you tell me?
Why do you think he was crying?
I don't know. I guess he ain't want me here.
Can't walk and can't get out there and get that money, you too.
Better paying and higher level jobs, that's what we need here. Then we're not gonna go for those cheap jobs. I hate my job.
You know, like all I do is just sit there, you know, and just wait for cars to come in and make sure they pay and to drag it. Just stay there and try to pass some time, you know. Kill time. The main thing is to kill some time. Kill that time. Kill that time. Yeah, when I'm in the gatehouse, I usually look like, you know, I can look right across the street, straight to that variety shop, and I look and I just see all those guys hanging there in the corners. Like you can see, like they're in their own world, you know.
I'm employed, mayor of New York. I got kicked out of office, so.
I used to be just like that at one time. You know, drinking in the corner, you know, hanging out. The junkies, shooting dope.
You
talking to people who get frustrated. You talking to drug addicts. You talking to winos. You talking to people who sleep down in those basements.
The people that don't have nothing to do.
No.
You talking about depression. You talking about the kind of depression where a man hanging around all day long, he gonna go to the liquor store and buy some wine. He don't have nothing else to do but sit around and talk bullshit. He come around and sit on the corner and say, well, man, let's plan to get some money. Let's go stick up a bank.
Give those people's job, you will stop the crime. Give those people's home, you will stop the crime. Give those people something to live for, and you will stop the crime.
Look at, man, it's not a white or black question. It's a question about the have and the have-nots.
But when you're out there in the street, your kids, stealing is a game. But once you start getting older, you ain't got no alternative but go on the streets and try to get that dollar. Because you ain't gonna make it if you don't.
Houses, you slam the door and the plaster comes down off the ceiling.
You know what it is?
You go to flush the toilet and it comes up back to you.
You know what it
rats
is?
Come through the toilet.
Some people gonna steal regardless to whatever the situation is. But we not talking about that small amount of people. We talking about this category that wanna work.
America!
We know by birth, we all Americans. But then, we all not given part of that American pie, that great American dream. To a lot of black people, that was the dream to you was a nightmare to me.
I told my man, right? Man, if you want something, don't hit me, because that breaks my mind. Understand? And he broke my stomach, you see? So I gotta do this shit. Understand? And then... I had the outpour going on, you see what I'm saying? So I licked it all up, like this, see? Then I'm finished, and that's it. And that's what you call morphine.
You go into an employee's office and you look at that. How you gonna find work with that?
Oh, yeah.
If I got the steel to get over, I'm gonna do it. Because my kids are not gonna go hungry out here. I don't give a damn for who. I'm gonna steal and get it. I'm not gonna break in no houses, no nothing, but if I see a nigga come down the street or a white man, anybody come down the street, and they got $20 in hand, I'm gonna snatch it.
Money. We didn't care if
it
was from somebody as poor as us. We looking out for
no,
us.
No, no.
It's like that.
I never
bothered
the poor lady, I don't think.
But how you know who you robbing?
You don't think. You
how
don't
you know who you
robbing? Why you know why you know man, but he carried himself.
No, it ain't like
I told
that,
you right there, nigga person got money.
It ain't
now.
Like
crazy.
That. Man could dress neat and still be poor.
No, not no. No. You crazy.
Man, that's crazy.
Now, you
hey,
not poor.
Not poor.
Some
people do that.
Yeah, not the best of dress.
Don't you think you dress neat?
I dress neat, but I don't dress superb.
Today and tomorrow, 25 to 30. The low this evening near 20. This is John Maher. Right now, 21 degrees in New York.
I've been stealing from the rich all my life. I mean, ever since I started. Ever since I started hustling, I've been stealing from the rich.
You know, you can't think about your motherfucking mind about who you taking it from. You taking it from. That's the bad part about it. That's the wrong. That's the fact. That's the basic fact. You can't feel personal about who you taking something from. It'd be you couldn't even sleep. You digging? I'm quite sure the right. Motherfuckers in here that took off 1,000 motherfuckers. You digging? They sleeping good.
Oh,
you know why?
Sure
because it's necessary to take somebody. If you ain't got no job, if you ain't doing nothing, you got to get yeah, over, geez, survive. You got to do something. You dig? So you take a motherfucker if you don't pay no attention about who he is. What he look like, who his mama is, who
just
his mama's mama
his
is, as long as his pocket is full and
got
like that, you
it.
Sober. That's your
that's
main concern.
So.
Let me tell you something, y'all get the wrong interpretation of crime down here. It's not crime, you know, you got a job, you work. We don't have no job, you know. What we do because we have to do.
Like, if you go to a job for 8 or 9 hours, why go to the streets
for
24 hours?
I can right now. I can be a head bookkeeper or assistant accountant, junior accountant, right now. But why I can't? I don't have no BA. I don't have no AA. I'm in school now for it. While I'm in school, how am I gonna eat?
It's about time I make a change.
Out of everybody in here, there's only two people with jobs.
Thousands of immigrants came to this country without money, without education, without a place in this society, and got all those things and succeeded. How do you account for their success?
How do you account for their success?
What's graduation cards?
Wait a minute.
What color immigrants are you talking about?
Your dad?
No.
All kinds?
All kinds. They came from baby. They got 40 weekends.
First.
The Irish. The Italian. Look at the Italian.
Japanese. The Chinese.
Gangsters. Look at Indians.
We was here first.
That was here first, and then it got shit. We is black.
Real.
We is the most despised, you know, people in the world. We don't get shit. What we get, we take.
I be on money.
You know, because don't nobody give us nothing. My mama might tell me I've been working with Macy's for 17 years. And they been doing me good. She been having that red flower for 17 years. She ain't got no motherfucking promotion. You dig? They even got my mama brainwashed. So they can brainwash my mama. You know they gonna try to brainwash her son.
But he ain't going like
and
that.
And I ain't going for that.
You a money maker.
You dig? I got a job right now. Motherfucker say something out of line. He don't see this on TV. He say something out of line. I can tell him kiss my motherfucker now. Because I got a choice, boy. I got a choice to break for you or take from you. You know?
Where do you draw the line in regard to violence?
It ain't no
line. Ain't no line.
It ain't no line. It ain't no limit to it. If I got to kill you to get mine, I'm going to kill you. And spend it.
You might as well say Nixon and took on Fort Knox. Now, if I can go take on Fort Knox and only be pardoned, and then that's when that line is drawn.
So
they
are
politicians.
If they're supposed to be helping us, how?
They killed Malcolm X because he was beating his sister.
Murder. They even killed one of your own.
You dig? They killed Robert Kennedy.
Because he was down with us.
He was down. He was trying to help everybody. And they iced him. If they don't want us to work, we don't work. They want to eat, they don't send no trucks down here. We won't eat. They got power over everything.
Concentration
camp. That's the way I feel. I give less than a fuck. That's the way I feel. This is a concentration camp. I've been around here 21 years. This is hell. Believe me.
I want to be somebody, you know, but I don't know exactly what I want to be, but I want to be somebody, you know. I want people to know that I was here, you dig? And I think that you're giving me a nice opportunity for me to look in this camera and tell anybody that, too. That I want to be somebody, because I do, man.
Those are my dreams, you know? Those are my dreams. You know, that someday that, you know, that people could see that we're just the same. You know, we're not animals, we're not this, we're not that, you know. It's just the same. Ordinary people, you know.
My dreams scare me. So I might go to jail, be in the hospital or something. Can't plan ahead.